What usually happens in old-fashioned drug development is that a compound is then first taken into what's called a phase one trial. So these phase one trials are very time-consuming, very risky, and enormously expensive.
The term drug repurposing broadly encompasses drugs that are already on the market, that are already in clinical use. They have been through the traditional drug discovery route. They're known to be affected on one disease. We're a good way through the project now. There are several compounds which are having a very good beneficial effect, and we're at the stage now of making sure that they still have those positive effects in the patient brain cells.
Also the ursodeoxycholic acid, or UDCA. So this is the drug we're trying to take into a clinical trial, which has already been in clinical use for more than 30 years. We know that this drug is safe. Thousands and thousands of patients have been taking this drug for decades at different doses.
We already know it's safe for use in man. We already know the doses at which it can be used. We already know if there's any long-term side effects with a lot of the compounds, which would be important thinking about a treatment for Parkinson's patients. If it was a novel drug discovery route, then that phase of toxicology and safety testing can take 5 or 10 years.
Of course, this will make it so much cheaper to do the clinical trial, and then hopefully also it will make it so much cheaper to actually put real patients in real life onto these drugs. My message to Parkinson's UK supporters is, first and foremost, thank you. Thank you for all the support.
And a huge amount of appreciation for them taking the time to find out what the research actually does and get a little bit more information and more understanding.
I want to help them to have hope, and there is real hope now. And I'm confident that the world will be quite a different place in the not too distant future as far as disease modifying treatment for Parkinson's is concerned.
Without the funding from Parkinson's UK, whole swathes of research wouldn't take place. And they're really, really important research that the people affected by Parkinson's want to have funded and think is important.